Israel is again bombing southern Lebanon as the death toll from yesterday's strikes reaches 558, including 50 children. It was the deadliest day for the country in nearly two decades, with Iran warning Lebanon cannot become another Gaza.
A second day and another round of bombs falling on Lebanon. This town in the Bekaa Valley was hit yesterday and again today. The country has seen a mass exodus of the south, traffic jams stretching through the day and night. Most here can remember the 2006 war, the last time this many Israeli bombs fell on Lebanon.
For too long, Hezbollah has been using you as human shields. It placed rockets in your living rooms and missiles in your garage.
But nowhere is safe. And right now, at least 10,000 Australians are registered as being inside Lebanon. What we are seeing is psychological warfare, a war on nerves carried out by the enemy against all the people of Lebanon. Hezbollah has been returning fire, launching rockets into Israel, but most were stopped by its missile defense system.
To all the parties involved in this conflict, is step back from the brink. Stop the escalation.
It appears neither side is willing to do that now. Iran, which backs Hezbollah, is accusing Israel of dragging the region into irreversible war. From our foreign minister,
we wish to see de-escalation. We believe a wider regional conflict is not in the interests of any of the peoples of the region.
But protesters here want more action.
It's time to end this war. It's time to end this genocide. And the Australian government has a lot more it can do to end cooperation with the genocidal state of Israel.
Here at home, there is a huge Lebanese-Australian community, around a quarter of a million people, who are deeply affected by the events of the past 24 hours. These snap rallies organised tonight in Sydney and in Melbourne are a chance for them and their supporters to have their voices heard.
My heart goes out to my Lebanese brothers and sisters who have been standing in solidarity with us, and so today we're showing up to do the same.
To help us as an Australian Lebanese to protect our family, to stop, and we need, everybody wants peace, nobody wants war.
And nobody is prepared for what might come next. Tallulah Thompson for 10 News First.